We are trying to predict possible mutants of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, also known as COVID-19. My name is Alejandro Ortigas-Vásquez. I am originally from Lima, Peru, and I am in the fourth year of my honors bachelor of science on bioinformatics program. The bioinformatics is basically the use of computational tools and software to study and analyze biological problems. So, for example, you can analyze a whole genome, which would normally take you a very long time if you try to do it by hand. But using a computer, we can look through, you know, hundreds or even thousands of genomes at the same time, compare them in some way, and obtain valuable information from that. I heard about Lakehead by first doing a little bit of research on Canadian universities, trying to see which ones were offering a bioinformatics program. And I got interested in Lakehead because I really liked the way they had designed their bioinformatics program, and it was one of the few universities that seemed to have really structured it well and focused on kind of the approach that I wanted. After my first term here at Lakehead, I started a research project concerning human papillomavirus type 16, and the Summer School of Medical Imaging was an opportunity that allowed me to finance that work while also learning a lot about the different aspects of medical imaging as a discipline. In the middle of the summer, I received an email for a call of applications for this MyTech's Research Training Award. So I decided to contact one of my professors, Dr. Willy Floriano. We submitted a proposal and we were lucky enough to be selected. The award itself was going to last 16 weeks, but we're continuing this project and we plan to carry it all the way to publication. Essentially, we are trying to predict possible mutants of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, also known as COVID-19. We're currently trying to find possible treatments to try and combat this virus. But the problem is that, as many viruses do, this virus can mutate, and all of a sudden it can become resistant to the drugs that we want to use to try and fight it. So what we're doing is we're actually using computational tools to try and predict what these mutations might look like. And based on that, we can also know which drugs are most likely to become ineffective in the long term. All the information that I need to do my research is actually available online. I can access some of the computers that are in the university from a remote desktop and work from the comfort of my home. In terms of achievements, I think that the most important thing that Lakehead has given me is the independence of taking on new challenges and doing something with them. The way in which classes are structured that allowed me to have a lot more independence as a student and as a person. All those things, I think, have contributed for me to become the person that I am now. There's still a lot that can be done because now we have access to resources that are available to everyone online. I think that ever since I arrived at Lakehead, there just seems to be a constant stream of new opportunities. For someone who's going into research, it is crucial to have research experience, and Lakehead has been absolutely invaluable in that regard because this is already opening quite a few doors for me, and I'm sure that it will continue to do so all the way throughout my career. I think the main reason why I chose Canada was because from the beginning it felt very welcoming to international students such as myself. There's a big thing where a country, you know, the second you arrive, they already, you know, give you a work visa and a SIN number. I think there's just something really welcoming out there, and it makes me want to give back. And I don't think that many countries really appreciate international students as a resource as much as Canada does. So currently we've looked at three different reported mutants of COVID-19. Predicting how much of an impact research is going to have is difficult. There are a lot of moving parts. So far, I'm very hopeful of the results that we've been getting. One of our hopes is to design a tool, a web-based tool, that encapsulates this method and allows other people to use it at their convenience to try and predict mutants on their own. And this just accelerates
a research process so much more, you know, having access to this much data, because it's basically turning into one big project. And the way to go moving forward is to have more of this, you know, crowdfunded public access initiatives.